Hi, this is Paul Del Rio from Packy. When a paving crew lays down a new asphalt roadway, who is ultimately responsible for that product and its construction? Well, this duty belongs to the quality control, or QC, technician. They follow the asphalt product, testing for quality and consistency from the stockpile all the way to the finished road surface.
There are many tests used to determine the engineering properties and quality of the asphalt being produced. Quality control technicians working for the contractor play an integral part in ensuring that the asphalt mixture performs well on the roadway. All of the raw ingredients used in the finished roadway must first be tested for quality, and this requires qualified technicians and a certified laboratory. The aggregates and the liquid asphalt, which are essentially the rocks and glue, are often tested well in advance of the actual construction project. Since liquid asphalt acts as the glue holding the mix together, it is essential to determine its properties to ensure that the mix will perform in the field under traffic conditions. The liquid asphalt is stored in large tanks at a terminal facility and is tested on a certain frequency utilizing several sophisticated machines. Technicians can determine how the binder will behave at extreme hot or cold temperatures, its properties after significant aging, stiffness, viscosity, and its ability to recover from loading. The aggregates used in an asphalt mixture are vital to the rut resistance and performance of the surface and must also be tested. Since the stockpiles at the quarry are so large, it is imperative that technicians first obtain a representative sample. Laboratory tests will be performed to determine properties such as angularity, specific gravity, which is the weight of the aggregate compared to the weight of the same volume of water, the presence of elongated pieces, and the strength of the aggregate. Perhaps the most important aggregate test is to determine gradation. Gradation is a description of the different sizes of aggregate present within a sample. Some specifications require blends using all smaller aggregates, whereas other mixtures may utilize a blend of fine, medium, and coarse aggregate. Once the raw ingredients are deemed acceptable, engineers and technicians will develop what is called a mix design. Like a recipe in baking, the mix design determines the proper blend of materials needed to produce the desired asphalt mixture during full-scale production. Technicians will first produce small batches of the mixture in the laboratory and perform a battery of tests. The asphalt material is compacted in a lab machine, producing what is commonly called a pill. The technician will test pills for several engineering properties, including susceptibility to water damage, the amount of liquid asphalt, specific gravity, and the amount of air voids or space between the rocks present. With the ingredients checked for quality and a mix design that meets the project specifications, it's time to produce a mix at the asphalt plant. During production, the technician will collect asphalt samples from a loaded dump truck and check the quality of the mixture. It's important to remember that most of the raw materials in the mix are naturally occurring and contain variability. This requires constant monitoring and subsequent adjustments at the asphalt plant where the final mix is produced. Once the truck reaches the job site and is unloaded into the paver, the technician will check the temperature of the mix and perform a visual inspection. Special testing gauges are used during construction to check the density of the mat. After the asphalt is compacted and cooled, cylinders of pavement called cores can be drilled out and examined for thickness, density, and air voids. From the stockpiles to the roadway, a quality control technician is essential for a consistently successful paving operation. Their education and experience make asphalt paving a truly scientific endeavor.